And there's that 10-second mark, so we know for sure that it's broadcasting. Well, as sure as we can possibly know. Hey, folks. Nathan Butler here. This is my YouTube channel where you can find things like From the Star Wars Home Video Library, Guide to Disney Infinity for Star Wars fans, my vlog, The Voice of Reason or Lack Thereof, reviews of Fantasy Flight games, materials, and more and more and more as I try to sit up straight so they can see you in the little box. Of course, you can find my Star Wars Timeline Gold, the most comprehensive Star Wars chronology available anywhere. You can find that over at StarWarsFanWorks.com/timeline. And you can find the two podcasts that I'm involved with, Cloud City Casino, a Star Wars gaming podcast with me and Michael Morris over at StarWarsReport.com. And alongside it, Star Wars Beyond the Films, where me and Mark Herleman talk about Star Wars canon and legends, stories, and whatnot. This is what, for a little while at least, may be the last of the Let's Plays for LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens. In the past 9 parts, covered from the beginning of the game up through the story of the movie, and then jumped into those unlockable special new missions that are new stories slightly based on canon but not entirely and so forth, like Poe Dameron rescuing Admiral Akbar and so forth. Got to the point where we were through the first 4 of those. Now we're going to tackle 5 and 6, and that'll be it, since I'm not doing free play on stream, until we have some DLC released, DLC level packs and whatnot released. So let's dive right in where we left off. For what it's worth, part of the reason why we needed to leave off at all was the fact that as you are unlocking things, you must do some free play, including some of the hubs, in order to play these 2 missions. Essentially, doing free play on a level to get all the collectibles and True Jedi and the Red Brick, all that stuff. Getting all 3 of those gold bricks, hello, is going to help you progress towards unlocking these levels. And if you play it in story order for the film and then check out those extra missions, then by the time you need 10 gold bricks, you'll already have 36 of them. By the time you need 20, you'll already have 39. By the time you need 30, you'll have 42. By the time you need 40, you'll have 45. By the time you need 50, you'll only have 48. As soon as you get to the point where there's only 2 of those unlockable missions left, you absolutely have to do some free play inside one of the hubs. So I have, and where we stand now is 160 out of 180 of the mini kits. That's all the mini kits except for the 2 levels that we're going to check out today. Hopefully, if time permits. 76 gold bricks, so I'm well past the 60 needed for that last unlock. 16 out of 18 red bricks, again, because I haven't done those other 2 missions yet. 16 out of 18 true Jedis, again, haven't done the other missions yet. 6 out of the 35 carbonite blocks, that's all the ones from Dakar, this location that I'm standing in now. 208 out of 253 characters, holy crap, that's a lot. And then 74 out of 85 ships, and no, JL, I do not play Pokemon. Any form. The closest I ever came to any kind of Pokemon stuff was about a month of playing the trading card game way back in the day with a buddy of mine who was really into it. Okay, so we're going to take off at the space. Ooh, it's like a constellation and everything. We have 2 missions to check out. Trouble Over Tall being the first. The other one is Ahtigan Assault. Again, I have not touched this at all yet, so this is all new to me. Before we go, I'll try to make sure to check out the free play thing real quick, though, so you can see the various character packs that are available, because they did recently release a couple from the season pass, and the 2 pre-order bonus ones have been made available for $2 each. But let's get going. We have Trouble Over Tall. The First Order is desperate to locate the main base up. The main base of operation, as opposed to operations, of the Resistance, believing that they have located a high-profile resistant ship in the vicinity of the planet Tall. They have sent a strike force after them to extract the information. Wait till you know the bottom of the paragraph shows up so we know what we're reading. Detecting the approaching threat and hoping to evade capture, the Resistance crew risks everything and flees into the treacherous asteroid belt surrounding the planet. Probably none. I'm assuming that's like the anniversary of his death. Yeah, probably none. I am working my way through Andromeda right now. Got 3 seasons to go of that, and then I'm going to start a massive marathon of all the Star Trek stuff. We're going to talk Enterprise, original, animated, original crew films, next everything. Which is going to take me a long time, but still probably not as long as it took for all of the Law and Order stuff. Poor guy? Poor guy who seemed to be like in a bathtub or something? Hammerhead Chip, originally, of course, from the KOTOR games.
This situation seems remarkably familiar.
Is that the chicken? See, it won't be Vader walking through the door. So, it'll be either Phasma or it'll be, Phasma.
We've already entered Tal's gravitational field.
The odds of this vessel surviving Tal's corrosive atmosphere are 728 million to 1.
Is that all?
Pity. 727 million to 1, and I'd have taken.
I'm interested in odds, Henri. You're here to find other protocol droids on this ship and interpret resistance data.
Hey.
Seek out and eliminate resistance personnel. I want those plans.
Eliminate more plans again?
And move up.
Alright, hello, Cinematrain, and have I watched Rebels? Yeah. In fact, I had a podcast. Whoa, there we go. Had a podcast dedicated to discussion of Rebels until recently. Star Wars Sports Rebels Roundtable. Let me pull up the thingy here. Oh, wrong one. Let me pull up the other thingy here. I want to show you what I've got active, and I'll turn off the tracker. So I've got Stud Magnet on. Fast Build is on. Fast Interact is on. Studs times 8 is on. Studs times 2 is on. Studs times 6 is on. Destroy on contact, which lets you like bump into something and have it destroy instead of having to punch it. Super slap, which lets you like bust through the wall and stuff. Studs times 4 is active. Regenerating hearts is active. Super detonators is active. Super silly sabers is not. Imperial inaccuracy is on, which I think is this stuff. Fast force is on. Studs times 10 is active. Infinite torpedoes. The funk awakens. Collecting guide stuns. The Funk Awakens is not turned on. Disco Sabers, it doesn't matter because I'm not going to be using a saber, but I'll turn that off. Squeaky Voices are not. Collectible Detector is, but I'll turn it off because I'm not doing free play. Silly Torpedoes, yes, and Super Strength is. There's only 2 more red bricks I haven't gotten yet. And notice it's cumulative, right? So the stud thing, I pick up 1 stud, now it takes that times 2, times 4, times 6, times 8, and then times 10. So 1 stud is like up in the thousands of studs. Like, I think it's like 3,000 something of studs. So hitting True Jedi is a given within the first few seconds of a level, which is nice. Kill the rebel scum! Are those explosive? Nope. Apparently not. I'm noticing there aren't any little yellow things popping up here. I'm betting that's what the Rebel Imperial inaccuracy thing is. It's keeping your... Why is it not hitting him? It's keeping your baddies, your enemies, from being able to knock you out. Why is this not... There we go. Get your ass out here.
They have too much cover. I can't hit the one by the airlock.
Leave him to me.
That must have been the fast interact thing that was done just now. Come on! There we go. Bye! Yeah, fast interact and whatnot and fast force lets you bypass some of those little mini games, like lining up the binocular thing or the scanner. Can't do anything there because I don't have anybody, I don't think, who's got a... Nope, an explosive. Nope. How about the original versions? Hard to say. The last time that they were saying that they claimed that they were putting out the original unaltered version of Star Wars films on DVD, for instance, they actually used the definitive edition from 1993, just with the beginning of A New Hope swapped out for a high-quality film print master. Since there had never, ever been a home video release, contrary to popular belief, never a home video release that didn't have a New Hope subtitle on the crawl, if it had a crawl.
La, la, la.
My servos are reporting a stability.
Gravity generators fluctuating.
Aight. Heal, heal, heal. All right, so we got that. Hey, requires a protocol, Jordan. I got one of those. Notice again, fast interact. It did not have me actually do any of that stupid match the pattern thing. Same thing with this.
Yes, behind here.
You usually would not be able to break that down without somebody that has that special ability, but now that I've got super strength as my red brick, I can just bust that sucker open.
The control panel appears too damaged. It's quite inoperative.
I say she may have been able to in the first place. It's hard to... No. It's been so long since I actually looked at that guy that... Check if I don't even remember. Depends on what kind of master they've got.
Search all of their records.
And yeah, did anybody not think he was going to implode on himself?
Boop. I scanned all 1.4 exanodes of data.
That's a lot of data.
Transmissions matching our search parameters were made. Additionally, their map files are inaccessible from this terminal.
Then we will search elsewhere.
Dang it!
We'll head for the bridge.
Assuming it's
go
still
back
to
fucking Phasma! Brienne of Tarth and all that. Remember, the unaltered ones have a... there's some legal issues with that beyond just the whole Fox thing. Because you got the whole issue of profit sharing of the original cuts. That's why the original cuts had to be a bonus feature in 2006. As opposed to having a separate release for themselves. La la la. 124 million studs just for this mission alone so far. La la la.
Hold them back.
Die!
Show no mercy.
For what?
Show no mercy.
Finally, a Star Wars game that again gives me a chance to bust out the old Destro quote. And I'm just trying to get through the levels, not necessarily search for collectibles, so I'm trying to just kind of zip around.
Access is fractured.
Uh-oh.
Train for this trooper. Do your duty. Wipe out the enemy.
And this and all things will be show our duty. A little bit of Hamlet there for ya. I've noticed that none of these guys have been doing that whole yellow targeting thing to say that they're about to be a threat to you. So that has to be the inaccuracy thing I was... talking about on the
it's happening again.
Choices.
The
red bricks.
Good news. One more and we'll be back to normal.
Concentrate on the enemy.
Yeah, neither should be on the ballot, but again, it's almost the Batman thing, right? What's the Batman thing? How, you know, I may not be the hero Gotham deserves, but I'm the hero it needs or something. Or the other way around, not what it needs is what it deserves. We don't have the candidates we need at this point in time, but we certainly have the ones that we in our effed up culture deserve.
I am not built for this.
Wow, you have a set of superficial, corrupt, narcissistic candidates who seem only in it for their own personal aggrandizement. Golly, that doesn't sound like anything in American society, does it? I doubt they would release unaltered ones in 3D just because I doubt they're doing that kind of conversion. They'd probably do that kind of conversion to the more recent ones. It's possible, I guess.
I'm surprised I could even
the big rumor right now
safe?
Through
It won't last long, though. Someone must have realigned an atmosphere containment force field. They lose power while we're in here.
So sorry.
What's in here? Oh, there we go. The big thing now is that there's, of course, the rumor from the Digital Bits that then was reported on by MakingStarWars.net, which was that... What is wrong with that? That is one sturdy water container. That's all I got to say. The whole thing about how later this year, as they promised, we will be getting The Force Awakens on 3D Blu-ray, but that we'll also be getting the other films that have been... already converted and shown in 3D as well. We'll be getting, theoretically, the prequels. Because the prequels, of course, were... Phantom Menace got a theatrical release in 3D, but then the other two were shown at Star Wars Celebrations. So we know they exist. Whether we would ever get the originals... we'll see. If they release unaltered films, will they have the truncated fanfare? They would almost have to.
All hands abandon ship.
Unless there is a deal with 20th Century Fox for the releases just to allow them to have the fanfare. And the chances of them saying, here, let's give 20th Century Fox a cut of the profits of five of these six movies where we don't have to just so we can use their fanfare, I think is very unlikely. But I think they have to on physical versions anyway. It's the digital releases where I think the deal doesn't exist. The current requirements don't exist, which is why you'd have only the digital releases in 2015, whatever it was. Only the digital releases had the truncated fanfare, not the more recent physical releases. At the time that the deal was being made for the distribution of the films on physical media, digital media wasn't even a thing yet. So there's a kind of a different process for that, different requirements because of when that arrangement was created.
They were protecting the bridge. They must be hiding.
Remember, Episode 7 didn't even really have a fanfare. Really? I'm waiting for them to do like a Marvel-style fanfare with that. That panel.
Oh, nice to
Mr. Threats.
See a familiar face.
We need the location of the Resistance base. I believe you may have it.
What this? No. This is a birthday card.
Where's the base?
Hey, 99, whatever its name is. One of the ones from before the Awakening.
Times like this, I have always found an escape pod to be a most useful appliance. They are designed to withstand a wide range of events.
Evacuate. We have what we need.
What the? What the hell did I just play? So they think they're looking for plans and they wind up getting a ship where that C-3PO is on, and in doing so lose the plans, and turns out there's an escape pod full of band people. Someone was smoking something. almost 2 billion. Whatchamacallit, studs. Only two of the things. Again, eventually I'll do the free play. The Stedrick Star, that must have been that ship that was on it. Hey, too fast! Yeah, lots of characters now. Oh, that's going to be another one that needs to be pay unlocked. Not bad, even though that was a stupid level. This did not make a whole lot of sense. Even the hoo at the end that just screamed, that's all, folks. All right, so let's unlock some more people. So I've gone through and I've spent the studs to unlock all the ones that have had their, up to this point, have been essentially unlocked for purchase, but then you have to pay studs to actually play with them. We've got a couple that are still locked. Here's one from this newest mission. Notice there are some of these that are flickering, kind of. There's one of these that's locked, but then you got the other versions of Han Solo here. But basically any of these, like say, oh, what's a good one? Rey. Right, so here's Rey, right? So if I hit R1 or L1, it instead of having different circles, different icons for each version of Rey, it's one for Rey, and I just click through the different versions of Rey that I can play as. And if you got one like this, that's just black, that's one you can still purchase, like those. And then you got your custom ones that you can create inside the resistance base to have whatever abilities you want. The thing that I find trickiest is ones like this, like Kylo Ren hooded, Kylo Ren unmasked, and there's still one that's locked, but it's flickering through them, so a lot of times it's hard for me to spot whenever something's been unlocked that can be purchased. Speaking of purchases, again, we had the Empire Strikes Back character pack that was available at launch for those who pre-ordered anywhere. It is now available on PlayStation Network Store, and I'm assuming Xbox Live Arcade Store, Xbox Live Store, whatever, Xbox Live Marketplace, for $2. That's the one with the Boba Fett prototype, Bossk, Dengar, Han Solo on Hoth, Labat, Luke Skywalker on Hoth, Princess Leia on Hoth, and the Ugnaught. And then, of course, we have Aayla Secura, Ki-Adi-Mundi, Kit Fisto, Luminara Unduli, Mace Windu, Plo Koon, Saisi Tin, and Shaak-Ti as the Jedi character pack. The Empire Strikes Back one comes with Slave One. Jedi character pack is the one that's exclusive to the season pass. You only get it if you buy the season pass, but it was available immediately. That includes a Jedi Starfighter or Jedi Interceptor from Episode 3. Then if you pre-ordered at GameStop, you got the Jabba's Palace character pack, which also just got released for $2 if you didn't have it otherwise. But apparently they rolled it into the season pass, even though it wasn't listed as part of the season pass, so you can get it for free. That's Bib Fortuna, Bush, Gamorrean Guard, Jabba the Hutt, Malakili, the Rancor Keeper, Max Rebo, Ula, and Princess Leia from Jabba's Palace, also known as Slave Leia. Then, of course, you have the droid character pack that's available for free right now as a timed exclusive for Sony systems. Eventually, it'll be released for other systems with Battle Droid Commander, Commando Droid, ME-8D9, General Grievous, IG-88, R5-D4, Super Battle Droid, W1-LE, and then you get to the prequel character pack, which is also part of the season pass. And available for $3 separately, we have Anakin Skywalker Damage, Captain Panaka, Darth Maul from The Clone Wars, Jango Fett, Jar Jar Binks, Padme Dabari, Watto, and Zam Wissel. And then from the Freemaker Adventures, we have another Season Pass character pack, which is also available now by itself for $3, with Bash, Grabala the Hutt, I love that name, Cordy Freemaker, Nare, Ram, Roger, Rowan Freemaker, and Xander Freemaker. The Freemaker Adventures one comes with their ship from the show. Prequels as a Naboo Starfighter, and Battle Droids is a droid starfighter, Vulture Droid. Okay. Jabba the Hutt's vehicle, it's the Sail Barge that's available. So a ridiculous number of characters at this point that are available. And yeah, my wife and I have finally caught up. We've watched all the Freemaker stuff so far. Apparently they're going at least to an episode 14 because they talked about a 14th episode in the newest issue of Insider. Let's get on to that last mission at Arthon, the Ottigan Assault. Which I don't think has anything to do with drugs or Bill Cosby, but maybe. Or Bill Clinton for that matter. I feel your pain and your boobies with the pretty pops. Ottigan Assault. An Ottigan enclave on the planet Arthon have bravely assisted the Resistance in their search for Luke Skywalker. Using the Great Eye of Kalur, they have mapped his location and given the only copy of the data to Lor San Tekka. Holy shit! That's how they got it? We didn't know that. But the First Order are also seeking Luke Skywalker and a dispatched Star Destroyer to Arthon. Owing them a great debt, the Resistance sends ships to help evacuate the peaceful Ortegans. That would have been great to, like, get out of, you know, the other materials that already exist out there. So they find out that Lor San Tekka gets it here, but they find out that he's got it through what happens in Before the Awakening, and then Poe gets his orders to go looking for Lor San Tekka in Before the Awakening, which crosses over then to the Poe Dameron comic. Then the Poe Dameron comic happens, then Before the Awakenings, or not Before the Awakening, then, is it Before the Awakening? Then we get to see basically the start of the film. Huh. Interesting. Yow, it's ugly. A mega box set.
Is the evacuation proceeding to plan?
I mean, depends on.
Yes. Many
it'd be nice to see all the different versions, but there's way world, too many.
But we do not have enough ships for all in the Enclave.
Get everyone you can onto our transports. Four of our ships will be here momentarily.
Yow's ugly. Interesting.
Our way is to build from nature. We will not be confined to ships wrought of plastic and tin.
Just take that plant with you. The First Order could be here at any second.
What a moron. But that's okay. We won't get on a ship. We're gonna die. I have not seen any new products announced by Fantasy Flight Games at Gen Con today. I haven't been looking, though. They were announced, though, not ones that were announced on the website already that they just showed off.
Enclave confirmed. Fighters and transports dispatched and en route.
Good. The map will be in our possession soon.
Sir, the intelligence was several days old. Tekka may not be here anymore.
Even if Lor San Tekka is not, someone
so this takes place prior to Lor San Tekka's return.
And I will tear that information from their mind.
We're detecting resistance ships gross. On the surface. They knew we were coming. They're trying to evacuate.
They will not succeed.
Hold on to that steering wheel, so to speak.
Comms activity suggests that transport ahead to be a command vessel of some kind.
Bring it down.
True Jedi already.
Oh,
too easy with them codes. Or not the codes, the red bricks that you actually earn.
Be very careful not to destroy that ship, Captain. Failure to gain the location of the map will not reflect well on you. When we get back to the finalizer, remind me to discipline those pilots.
Yes, sir. Will there be anything left for me to discipline afterwards?
Doubtful.
She kind of scary.
There are more transports escaping, sir.
They are of no importance, Captain.
Watch out, sir.
This actually looks pretty decent.
I think they're trying to make a run for it, sir.
They will not succeed.
Yes, I heard that, Lego fan. I wasn't entirely sure why. I thought it was like people being just nasty, but I'm not sure how. Like it, what the context was. There we go. I was like,
more
what
targets
am I trying
incoming,
to shoot?
Captain.
Nice. I guess that means that Michael and I will need to be digging into that stuff for the next Cloud City Casino. And there's another mini kit. Ah, so she made a political comment and people went apeshit. I can see that. We are in that atmosphere at this point. Very cool. I'll have to look at that stuff. I love the Fantasy Flight Games miniature material. It's just that I don't necessarily get to play as often as I'd like. I need to get Michael down here at some point, because he only lives about 45 minutes away. But hell, Riley and Bethany live like half an hour away, and we still haven't met down here. It's just everybody got so much stuff going on, we don't think about catching up in person. Let's get some more egg. Oh, and I missed it. That was pretty lame. One more. There we go. I think we talked about that last time, JL. I like the new one with the memorial built in. And the fact that it was fully built in.
This is Blue Six, going weapons hot.
They're sending more targets for us, Captain.
So the siege engines have locked onto us again.
I must not have the infinite torpedoes then. That's not what I'm trying to shoot. That's me trying to get more torpedoes. So what am I actually trying to... There we go.
Target their siege engines, Captain.
It's like he read my mind about what I was asking.
Be careful, Captain. Their siege engines are firing on us again.
Whoa! Pretty sure that I just flew through the, geometry. That's what she said. Oh god.
More fighters inbound.
No,
Captain.
I have no idea. Their re-releases tend to be for different media, so unless they're going to do like a 4K release or a 3D release.
They're attempting to land. Follow it down.
This month, I believe it is, we got the release of Rebels Season 3. So.
Sir, those turrets will make approach the air extremely risky.
Captain, you and I will deal with them personally.
What are these things made for? Ewoks.
Well, JL, you will have it! Possibly. If the digital bits is to believe, along with Attack of the Clones, along with Revenge of the Sith, along with The Force Awakens.
So
oh! Bye! Gave you the Lorsan Tekka treatment!
I landed on a mattress! I landed on a mattress! That's what she said!
Okay.
You can leave this to me.
Oh, I've got silly sabers or something on.
But I won't.
Because he's got the weird shapes and stuff to it. Let me see what... Oh, nope. Back off. Let's see what I actually have turned on for that. Not disco sabers. Got silly torpedoes turned on. Yep, super silly sabers. So I guess I'll just do disco sabers as well. Which changes the colors constantly. They're such silly sabers.
Why do they even try?
Each time they turn off or disappear, they come back as a different
good. It's just what I need.
Shape.
Unauthorized weapon fire detected. Lay down your weapons and await detainment by security forces.
How about y'all kiss my grits? Nope, you need a rebel for that. Ooh, red brick. Which red brick was that? Won't matter because I won't be able to activate it. You can't purchase a red brick and unlock a red brick in the middle of a mission. You can turn them on and off, but you can't, I can't spend the money. Come on. I can't spend the cash to turn that one on. Kylo Ren be like, I'm gonna bust this tree. And the Schnikey? They haven't announced anything, if it is. For 4K. Send it back! Okay. I was expecting that I was supposed to, like, grab it with the force and throw it back or something. Apparently not. Yeah, I would have assumed so. I just walked into it and it activated. That's that whole whatchamacallit. What the fuck? Characters with the force can press them to. Okay. I get that. And I'm holding it. Oh, okay. I didn't know you could target like that. If that's been present for the entire game, boy, did I miss out.
Until those blaster turrets are disabled, sir.
I think you mean until those blaster turrets are handy capable. Oh, need to pass my ears, the sheeping. Oh, maybe that mattered, maybe it didn't. There we go. Whoa! What in the hell was that? Thing. Oh, I've got to actually manually move it. What the heck?
A new target for you, Captain.
Oh, that sucked. Okay, I thought I was supposed to be using that to go after the ship. No wonder it wasn't working the way I was expecting it to. Why does his lightsaber... You mean, like, why does it look different right now? Or why is his different than everybody else's in the film? Man!
Perhaps this will help, Captain.
Okay. Except not really. Lucky day. Okay. It's because I've got super silly sabers and disco sabers turned on. Damn it! Fucking A! Come on! Now I'm starting to get frustrated and pissy. Nope. Nope. Switch to Phasma. Switch to Phasma. And Phasma's gotta shoot it. What the fuck? I pull it down with Kylo. I hit triangle. Oh, now it's staying in place. Every other time I let go as Kylo Ren and went to Phasma, it just went flying away for no freaking reason.
Shoot everything, Captain.
In the words of Will Smith from Bad Boys, my shit works all the time, sometimes. Or my shit always works sometimes, or something like that. Point being, it didn't work like it's supposed to. Sorry, Phasma. My bad. Yes, I know that was what I was trying to do, but every time that I clicked over, when it pulled up the little triangle to click over from Kylo Ren to Phasma, as soon as I did it, it started moving back. It wasn't until that last time where Kylo actually stayed holding on to it like he was supposed to. More of that glitchy partner AI. Oh! But fate got revenge on his ass, didn't it? Again, notice I just bumped into it, and as soon as I bumped into it, that's all I needed to do, because I've got a... whatever it's called turned on, where you walk into something to destroy it. There we go, and in comes more baddies. Or goodies, I guess, because he's Kylo Ren. What's up, bruh? Help us with the door, yo! Oh, she's got to command them, or he's got to command them. I would assume it's her, because usually... Stop it! There we go.
Troopers, get that hatch open.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, because usually you have to do the action with the character, and of course, the others don't have the... There we go.
Stay here and cover our retreat.
Affirmative.
Let's not keep the Audigan leader waiting, Captain.
Audigan? Not Artigan, Audigan. Interesting. So do they support the resistance or the First Order? Well, they're kind of odd again, off again, you know. Oh, I like the design of that silly saber, pitchfork type.
Kylo Ren of the First Order. You want to hear my First Order? Destroy the First Order.
That voice does not look like it should be coming out of that head. Okay, so just for the sake of making the point about the sabers. If I turn off disco sabers and I turn off silly sabers, they're back to normal.
Can you use the force to stop those rockets, sir?
Probably. What can I aim it at? I can aim it over there, apparently. And I apparently want to do something with that.
You are an abomination.
Your mom is an abomination!
The Sacred Order of Romulus is a peaceful sect. Your attack on our world is blasphemy. You'll fail, just like me.
Don't give him a guy a complex. It's bad enough that Rey is going to be able to figure that out later. Don't give him a complex about Vader. I mean, come on. All right, I need a Chewbacca for that one, apparently. She can't do it. Oh, hey! I can't get to it. Maybe a free play only type of... Yeah, because I got to be able to get through the gas. And again, for some stupid reason, Stormtrooper helmets in the Force Awakens era are not designed to keep out poisonous gases. Shoot another missile at me. Oh, wrong guy. Sorry. Phasma's just standing there like, what am I supposed to do with this thing? There we go. Figured there had to be some way to do it. Do you know what high school and college feels like? Yeah, I mean, I finished high school and... Of course, from different eras, right? When I finished high school, it was 1998. When I finished college for my bachelor's degree, it was 2002. So... My master's I did later.
You don't need to say anything. Your secrets.
I'm gonna probe your mind!
For long.
Ha! You'll find my will is stronger than.
When you were 5, you crashed your brother's speeder and blamed it on your friend.
Ha! Drat.
Sir, this area is becoming unstable. Perhaps we should withdraw.
Agreed. I have what we need.
Suck it out your mind! Out of your weird wannabe Ithorian with a beard mind. And that's how they figure out to go to Jakku, I assume.
I'm sorry, but we have to assume that your leader has been captured.
Sadly, I agree.
What are the chances he can resist interrogation?
0.
Send word to Admiral Statura. Taka is in danger. Poe Dameron is to go to Jakku at once.
And there is something... What the? I want to see that play into the Poe Dameron comic. That's how Poe finds out that they need to go to Jakku. Because that's what the Poe Dameron comic is all about, is him trying to find Lor San Tekka. Finishing the mission given to him in Before the Awakening. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is all of the missions from the core game. There will be 3 missions at least released as DLC, but that is the last of the 18 missions built into the core game.
Yeah!
Taking defense fighter. A digging defense fighter. Another Kylo Ren. A Tegan Acolyte needs to be bought. A Tegan Warrior needs to be bought. The Nero needs to unlock this. 4, 5. Alright, so there's 5 more that need to be purchased. That's purchased, not purchased, because purchased would be like this, I guess, on the back of the chair. You're perched on your ass. Physical comedy. Haha. Hello, Rabbit Hole. Good to see you here. All right, so let's see where we stand now. Let me go ahead and buy what's left. What's the one that's now available? Super Disco Blasters, which changes the blaster colors. So Super Disco Blasters, Super Silly Sabers, Disco Sabers, Squeaky Voices, Collectible Detector. I'll just turn everything on. So all that's left, I still need to get the I guess that's Infinite Torpedoes from the previous mission, the Tall mission, or Towel, or whatever. Sweet. And, alright, characters. Click, click. Bot. There was more. Yeah, right here. Alright. So the ones that are left are going to come from a combination of if there's any characters to unlock by getting the mini kits finished, and usually that's just vehicles that get unlocked. Or it'll be stuff that's going to be unlocked whenever I do free play and pick up those carbonite blocks and thaw them out. So they freeze them, thaw them out. So yeah. And oddly enough, it's still only 69.1% done. There's still stuff to get in both of those missions. There's still stuff to get as far as the various free play zones and whatnot. And I haven't ever done this, the Djarik thing. Djarik battle. Let's see what this is even about. But yeah, my plan at this point, for what it's worth, is... now that the story mode stuff is done, I'm going to stop... with the streams for this, because we've gone through all the story missions at this point, and keep working on free play off stream, with the idea being that eventually, once I get to the point where my free play is, get to a point where I'm done with free play, and at 100%, I'll pop up and show you all if I get to a point where I'm at, just want to kill the little guys. If I get to a point where there's a new DLC that comes out, I'll do a very quick stream to show you that. Maybe do a little bit of free play with it. But that's the goal. And then once they actually do put out... Wow, that's some serious cash. Once they finally do put out those level packs, I'll be doing those levels on the stream the first time that I go through them, just like I did with this other stuff. As for Battlefront live streams, there's not really a whole lot going on at the moment. I'm just sitting there basically working on the... Working on getting more credits to be able to unlock the upgrade version of the newest HUT contract. And then needing to do that. But I kind of feel like I'm not really doing much with Battlefront right now until I do another one maybe with Michael. Another stream with Michael. And that'll free me up from doing the streams for a little bit. I've gotten some new stuff to do episodes of From the Star Wars Home Video Library about. At least 3 new episodes of that need to be recorded that I have the stuff for. And then, I got some Fantasy Flight game stuff that I need to get put onto the Star Wars Timeline Gold and reviewed. So for a while, you won't see much in the way of streams. But that's just a matter of the prioritizing that's going on. It doesn't mean anything's ending, per se. Just unless there's something new to show, the priority needs to be on getting the timeline stuff ready to go. And the last few Fantasy Flight Games reviews that I haven't done. Okay, I am able to shift between them. Woo! If you have it, the new one, I mean, there's no new content in the newer one. It's just the 2011 stuff repackaged is all that it is. But if you much prefer that type of packaging, go for it. Or if you're a collector like I am, go for it. Are you going to make it through high school and college? I'm not sure what you mean by are you going to make it through. barring stopping for some reason. All that I see from the... I mean, I only see the stuff that they've released publicly as far as that stuff goes. My days of getting a lot of details beforehand... I guess technically I still get some details beforehand because of, like, the books. But that's all book stuff. It's not anything through EA or anything like that. I just keep up with the news very closely because that's what our one of our podcasts, Cloud City Casino, is about. So I'm paying much more attention to gaming news than I otherwise would. In fact, we just did an episode that was almost nothing but news that'll be released next week. But of course, it was right before Gen Con, so we don't have any of the new Gen Con news in it, unfortunately. Winner, winner, chicken dinner! Holy crap! This is a lot of studs! That's more studs than a Chippendales convention. Why did you change his arm? Whose arm? Oh, what is up with C-3PO's arm? Why did they change it? See the C-3PO The Phantom Limb comic. Basically, he's on a mission. You know how there's a mission on here where Poe Dameron has to go and save... I didn't even know that those were in there. Poe Dameron has to go and save... Admiral Ackbar. In order to get the information to save Admiral Ackbar, they're transporting a droid that has that information on a ship. The ship gets shot down. C-3PO and several droids, including that prisoner droid, are the only ones that make it out. On their way to a transmitter that'll let the Resistance know where to find them and pick them up. All the other droids die except C-3PO, or get destroyed except C-3PO and that prisoner droid. C-3PO gets an arm ripped off. The prisoner droid and him talk a lot. The prisoner droid has a change of heart, so to speak. Winds up sacrificing itself to get to the transmitter during an acid rain. So that C-3PO can be saved with the information that has been passed along from that droid to C-3PO. C-3PO takes the what's left of that droid's body, which is an acid wash, now red instead of silver arm, and attaches it in place of his old arm as a tribute to that droid temporarily. Ta-da! And it's not a very good comic. I don't want to say it sucks, but if it had a nickname, it would be Hoover. Whew! Cool. I'd be curious to know whether Star Wars HQ... It's Star Wars HQ, it sounds like a... If it's what I'm thinking of, it's a fan site. Which likely means a lot of... You know, kind of pulling together, culling together the information from what's known. But usually that also has a fair bit of... speculation with it as well. Cool, so that's even more that we're unlocked. Give me somebody with force ability. I usually go to Kit Fisto because I like the fact that... Oh, it's got to be dark side. Duh. Kit Fisto because he can do dark side and light side. Or not dark side and light side. Duh! I'm trying to speak without thinking here because I'm trying to figure out where I need to go for this. I need to grab Vader or somebody. No, I'd use Kit Fisto because he can use... the agility stuff, and he can use the lightsabers, and he can use the force, and he can do the underwater stuff. Oh no, I already did Wrathar hunting. I don't want no more Wrathar hunting. Wrathar hunting is like Goodwill hunting, but not nearly as cool a movie. Wah wah. Yep, another gold. Okay. Another gold brick. And this is basically, I mean, this basically is what free play is. It's just running around a location where there's going to be various gold bricks and carbonite blocks and whatnot. I mean, that's all that it really is. So... Will they bring Hayden Christensen back for anything? Yeah. I mean, if they ever want to have Anakin as opposed to Vader in something, they might but it would have to be something live action because they've got Matt Lanter voice wise. As a clone, I hope not. I think that, I don't know. People already complained enough about the clone of Palpatine in Dark Empire. Is it maybe this is like an evil clone or an opposite clone? So like he was evil and turns good and then turns evil again, right? So it's like a reversal. And they could go with the Zahn version of cloning and name him Anakin and have like the extra A in his name or something, the extra vowel. And then they could, you know, they can make him a complete opposite. He'd be like, I love sand. I love it in all my cracks and everything. Nothing makes my day like sand in an orifice. Wait, what? As a little code. So I should be able to break out a fire dude. I know I don't usually do the free play, but on the stream, but eh. That's fine. Oh, shit! Ooh, melty. Still needing to melt something more? Sorry! Seems like I need to melt this more. Maybe not. Maybe I gotta turn that thing off first and fix it first. So, how's about... At least when I kill Chewbacca, I don't get death threats like Salvatore did. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to think of who's got a toxic gas mask thing. I guess there's a Han Solo that does. Where's Han at? There we go. The Han Solo Tuan Kati. What the... Oh, no. It's the coldness. I keep thinking of the... Not the coldness, but the poison gas. Luke Skywalker Hoth should be able to do it. There we go. There we go. Yeah, because it was just constantly refreezing it. La la la. I need Vader again. There we go. Wah, 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 wah. Go, Brick. It's hard to kind of tell where those indicators are pointing because they're pointing outside the room, but you still see them through the room. There's some poison gas! There you go, Han. This is for you. Is that a mission? Oh, no. Okay, good. Ooh, Goldbrick! And an Ewok. Damn, how long has that Ewok been there? Because, I mean, this is 30 years after Jedi. Poor thing. Poor thing. Cool. Yeah, I'm going to be doing the 100% thing, but I'm not going to be doing it on stream. My goal was to just make sure to get through what exists now. Okay, I must have already done that one. Whoa! Now it's not the special editions that had the Ewoks blinking, it was the Blu-ray edition. Which is like two versions past the special edition. Oh, I'm back over here again. Yeah, that's all those little, whatever you call them, races. Races, missions, whatever. I see a purple. If I can get to the purple, I believe the purple is usually, I don't think, is that a carbonite block that's usually purple? Whoa! Well, you wouldn't think that Han would keep much carbonite on the Falcon. It'd bring back bad memories. Oh, and I hit the button that apparently made him jump out. Wonderful. Let's try this again. All I'm controlling is upwards and... Oh, I can go forward. Of the Atari. Oh, Shiva! Ah, shit! Oh, dead. Damn! I'll try it one more time, but I'm not gonna waste a whole bunch of time with it. I'll do it free play later. But space slugs coming after me. Whoa! Alright, that's farther than I got the first time. For real, how long is this dang minigame? Woo! There we go. Now I can show you guys how these work. Because it took me a while to figure out where I was supposed to take these. So that's a carbonite brick. Okay, I don't know that you can do anything with the carbonite bricks on the Falcon. I gotta go to map. I haven't actually messed around with the carbonite bricks or really much of anything on the Falcon. Where's the room? Where am I going? Hey guys, where's that map at, man? There we go, man. It's on Dakar. Yeah, that is one thing that is a little bit weird. The fact that you can't go to, you can't do the carbonite blocks, as far as I know, and Rabbit Hole is confirming it here, that you can't undo, thaw out the carbonite blocks anywhere but on Dakar. But they're scattered elsewhere, too. So... Yeah, I tell you, I like the mini games. I especially liked in Lego Star Wars, not Lego Star Wars, Disney Infinity 3.0, The Force Awakens playset. At Nima Outpost on Jakku, there is a mini game that's almost like Star Wars meets Asteroids, like a top-down shooter. It's awesome. Way more fun than any of the actual flying sequences in the regular game. Let's freak everybody out, man. It's Vader. Have I played the other LEGO Star Wars games? Yes. Years and years and years ago. Smash through them with my... whatever you call it. Here we go. The one that's got like a little medical-looking symbol. Well, this is where you can create your... I can actually show you how to make a custom character, because I guess I haven't ever bothered with it. Alright, so like, da-da-da, jump in. Do this, show you the carbonite block, and then be out of here. Click on custom A. Oh, golly, which face do I want? Which body? Which head color? What heads? What hair? What hat? Let's go with heads. Let's go with, kind of like the Sidon Ithano head. Any hair? Nope, because that's going to change the head. or the hat or the face, and so on and so on and so on, and then you decide, okay, well, what legs do I want, and yeah. Anyway, you just make your own character. I don't know. And apparently you get a trophy for having done actual customization of any kind, even if you didn't save it. All right, that's got a thingy in it, but I already took care of it. Smash, 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 smash. Go. And so you go to the little thing, you stand on it, you click it. Most of them I haven't picked up yet. I've already unlocked Gray Squadron Pilot, A-Wing Pilot, Rebel Fleet Trooper, Princess Leia Classic, Amber Ackbar Classic, and Zeb Seneska this way. The way that you do it is you're basically just, you know, you're unlocking classic characters, classic trilogy characters most of the time from these. And there's one that's still a brick. You're like, oh no, it's a carbonite brick. What could it be? Click. And I had no idea. I mean, I'm not surprised, but I didn't know. And ba-ba! Han Solo Classic? Is that what he's called? Probably. Yep, Han Solo Classic. There we go. So there's yet another one. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Which actually may be all the Han Solos now. Let me see. They are in it took me a while to figure it out. They are in alphabetical order, but then as soon as you get to the, it's like they're in alphabetical order up to a point. Once you get to Zev, and then once you get to the droids, they're essentially in alphabetical order. And then you got J.J. Abrams, Kathleen Kennedy, few of the monsters, customs, and then they're in order by pack after that. As if anybody actually needed to do that. But yeah, so we got Starkiller Base Han, Twan Kati Han, regular Han, Han Classic. Oh, there's still a Han. There's a Han Indoor too. Cool. So yeah, very cool. Rabbit hole, I guess, would be the last chance to answer a question because of time here. Go ahead. 225 out of 253, not bad, not bad at all. A species of aliens I particularly like. I'm not so fond of how they've been overused, but I like the Twi'leks and the reference and the comparisons to stuff like the French Revolution. Because I like the way they draw the historical parallels there. That kind of stuff. There you go. And just for sheer comedic value, the Zeltrons crack me up. The way they were used in the old Marvel series. Where Leia is constantly just like, oh my god. I cannot believe they just said that kind of stuff. Alright, but that being said. So that's all the story missions. Thus far, all 18 of them now live streamed. I'll be going back and doing more free play later. The next time there's a DLC released, whether it is a character pack or a level pack, I'll pop on to show you. When I hit 100%, I'll pop on to show you. And whenever they finally release those three level packs as, whoops, I pressed the button. As DLC, I will hop back on here and show you those as well. But for now, this will be it for a while for LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens. Thank you all for taking the time to check out the streams. Hopefully you'll check out some of the other content on the channel if you haven't yet. Maybe a Battlefront stream next, unless they have a real quick release of another LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens DLC pack soon. It'll probably be the next stream would probably be me and Michael together doing some Battlefront stuff, just depending on time. The next content will probably be some Fantasy Flight Games reviews and some From the Star Wars Home Video Library episodes. So, thank you all for watching. Again, this has been Nathan P. Butler. This is my YouTube channel where you can find stuff like From the Star Wars Home Video Library, The Voice of Reason or Lack Thereof, which is my Star Wars vlog. You can find the two podcasts that I'm involved with, Cloud City Casino and Star Wars Beyond the Films, both at StarWarsReport.com, and my Star Wars Chronology, The Star Wars Timeline Gold, the most comprehensive Star Wars chronology available anywhere at StarWarsFanWorks.com/timeline. I think I've got that almost down to its science, but I still trip over it sometimes. Again, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you later.